In this video, we'll conduct a basic comparison of the performance of firms. We'll wrap up our analysis of market structures with a focus on measuring performance by revenue, output, profits, efficiency, exit efficiency, barriers to entry, price competition, non-price competition, and collusion. We'll work through each of the market structures in turn and focus on the key characteristics of measurement for each one. In perfect competition, we'll focus on the measurements listed in dark text. Output is going to be higher than under less competitive structures such as monopoly. Profits can be supernormal in the short run, but will return to normal levels in the long run. This is largely due to the fact that there are no barriers to entry and exit. If supernormal profits are being earned in the short run, new firms can easily enter the market. The high level of competition results in productive and allocative efficiency for firms in the long run, as price equals marginal cost and firms produce at their lowest average total cost. Price competition is high as price is dictated by the market, therefore firms are price takers and have no price setting power. In monopolistic competition, output is likely to be higher than in less competitive markets. Profits are possibly supernormal in the short run and normal in the long run. Since price is above marginal cost and firms do not produce at their lowest level of average cost, there is no productive or allocative efficiency achieved. There are very low barriers to entry and exit, so entering and leaving the market is relatively easy. Price competition is high, but firms have some price setting power as they can differentiate their products. In an oligopoly, firms can restrict output to drive prices higher. They're able to achieve supernormal profits in both the short run and long run. Their prices are likely to be above marginal cost, which means they are not allocatively efficient. The production costs may not be at the lowest possible, so they are also not productively efficient. Exit efficiency can be an issue if their costs are not as low as they could be. Barriers to entry and exit are quite high, which is a key feature of a less competitive market. Price competition is unlikely as firms aim to avoid price wars, so the focus is more so on non-price competition. This is carried out through branding, advertising, after-sales service, and a host of other methods which have been discussed earlier. In this market, collusion is possible as firms may benefit from working together to achieve monopoly-like profits. In a monopoly, output is lower than in competitive markets. Firms are able to achieve supernormal profits in the short and long run. They are not allocatively efficient as the prices charged are higher than marginal cost. They are also not productively efficient as they are likely not operating at the lowest point of their average costs. However, a natural monopoly may charge a price equal to marginal cost and thus be allocatively efficient. Depending on where their average cost is, it may also be closer to productive efficiency. Dynamic efficiency is a likely outcome if the firm is using its supernormal profits to innovate and develop new products that meet the needs of the market. Exit efficiency is a likely outcome of the firm if it is producing at an average cost above what it potentially could be. Barriers to entry and exit are very high and result in a lack of competition. Monopoly firms may engage in price competition. Barriers to entry and exit are very high, which results in a lack of competition. Monopoly firms may engage in price competition to keep competition out of the market and may also develop their products to maintain their monopoly position. After watching all the videos in this unit playlist, you should have a pretty clear understanding of how the performance of firms varies across the different market structures. This video serves to highlight some of the key differences you should pay attention to and be able to clearly explain. If there's any part of this video or the playlist that's unclear, leave a message in the comments or email me directly at enhancedtuition@gmail.com.